To make sure that the enrollment process succeeded, log off from the client machine and log in again with the user credentials and check that he can authenticate with the certificate. Go to the Smart Endpoint console and then to Policy tab. Under One Check Policy, click the Authenticate Users with Password option and click Edit. Under the default Preboot authentication method, select one of the options that include Smart Card. Under the Smart Card Drivers section, select the relevant Smart Card or Token Drivers. Make sure you select the Smart Card or Token Drivers and the Reader Drivers. You can recognize whether the driver is for the Smart Card or for the Reader by looking at the Type column. Once you finish selecting the relevant drivers, click Configure and make sure that Scan User Certificates from Active Directory is selected. You can choose whether to scan all certificates or only user certificates that contain Smart Card Logon or ID. Then click OK. Click OK to close the window. The procedure we made for all users that will get this policy can be performed for one specific user. To do so, browse to the user you want, right-click it, select the One Check option and then select Preboot Authentication Method option. When clicking Modify, you will be presented with the same drivers window we had before. Close the window and go back to the Policy tab. Under the FDE policy, click the Authenticate User in Preboot option and click Edit. Click the Advanced Preboot Settings option at the bottom and then make sure the Enabled USB Devices in Preboot environment is selected. Then click OK. Click OK to close the window. Save and install the policy changes. To make sure that the changes were implemented on the client, check in the display overview that the policy number has changed. Reboot the machine and wait for the Preboot screen to appear. If the Smart Card or token is already inserted into the machine, you will be automatically prompted to enter the token password. Type in the password and click OK. If you have enabled SSO, it will be activated after the first authentication. Type in the token password again. We have finished configuring two-factor authentication with FDE.